Hi, welcome to my kitchen. This is Sofi and today I will show you how I make bread. As you know, bread is made out of flour, yeast, a little bit of sugar and salt, and water, of course. About 60% per volume is water. If you mix just these four ingredients, you get a pretty decent bread. But I usually add different seeds and different grains because you get a much tastier and more nutritious bread this way. I usually add rye, oats, flax seeds, sesame seeds, anise, barley, whatever I have. But at least one-third to half of the flour I use is bread flour, which is basically durum wheat, hard wheat with an addition of some barley. To the bread flour I add at least half as much whole wheat flour. I also substitute molasses for the sugar that I proof the yeast. Yeast likes it and makes better tasting bread, and the color is better too. I will make 6 or 7 loaves, so I will use here 3 tablespoons of yeast. It may seem like a lot, but it's only about 1 teaspoon or less of yeast per loaf. And I like my bread to rise. So I mix different flours in a big container, and I'm going to ground some anise seed, and also I'm going to ground some oats, which I'm going to add, maybe a couple of cups of oats I will add. So I grind 1 cup of oats in the blender and I add it to the mix. And then 1 more cup of oats and I add anise seeds and I ground that too. That goes to the mix too. And now hot water, I have boiling water, I put some molasses in it, and a little more hot water, I'll mix it so it dissolves. Oops, I'm steaming my lens. And then I add some cold water. I need to bring the temperature of the water between 108 and 115 degrees, because that's the ideal temperature for the yeast to proof. Okay, now this water is sweet because of the molasses, and I will just 112, yeah, temperature is right. I will just add the yeast in it and I will mix it to dissolve. Now this is a fast rising yeast, so I don't need to wait. I'll just dump all my mixed flours in there, and I'm gonna need to add more water, and I'll work it with my hands for about maybe 5 minutes. I will need to add a lot more water during that time, so it just looks about like that. And I'll wait about half hour or 45 minutes until the yeast, the dough rises, and when it has risen time and a half, then I will punch it down and make the loaves. Okay, now the dough has risen, I'm gonna put some olive oil on the countertop and I'm gonna plop the dough down on the counter, and I'm gonna punch it and squeeze it and turn it and be violent with it until I knock the air out of it and it becomes smaller and more pliable to form the loaves. I oil my pans a little bit, and then I will just spread the oil like this, and then I will add some oats or sesame seeds, or you can add corn maize, whatever you prefer, whatever you have handy. So it doesn't stick, the bread, you know, it doesn't stick, comes out easily when it's baked. So here's how I form the loaves. First, get a little bit of flour to drizzle over it, just in case it gets sticky at all. And make a sort of a flat pie, like a flat bread, Okay, and then we're gonna roll this bread into a loaf. So when it's flat, I put sesame on one side, I pat it down so it sticks good. And then, you know, I just turn the ends in and I roll it, and that's my loaf. I saw a baker doing that once. So now I'm gonna cut it all the way down to the countertop in slices, and this will make it easy to break the bread when it's done. You don't need a knife to cut this bread when it's cooked. You just cut one slice off. You just break one slice off. So here's some rolled oats at the bottom of the pans. And in goes the loaf. Just shake it, it fits in the bottom. Squeeze it down. Don't worry, it will rise up again. And I will form the rest of the loaves in a similar way. Now you can ask me, what do you want all this bread, woman? How much bread do you eat? 6-7 loaves in one sitting? No, I don't, but I do have friends and neighbors that they appreciate a bite of good bread now and then. So I give away some, and I freeze a bunch, you know, so when I thaw it, it's fresh like the first day you made it. Plus, bread takes the same amount of time and effort and expense to make one loaf or five loaves. So why not make more and share? Okay, that's my last long pan, but I have a couple of round ones, so I'm going to make a couple of round breads too. Same way, make a round a ball and kind of squeeze it until it's round like a pie. Dip it in sesame. You probably see I dip everything in sesame and I cover them well. I like sesame, I love it. Toasted sesame on bread. Smells like nothing else. I'll cut this like a pizza. 8 pieces. It breaks really easy when it's cooked, when it's baked. And one pan of bread rolls, and we're done. It's always a good idea to clean up as you go, so you don't end up with a royal mess in the kitchen by the time you're finished. So here are the loaves. I have to wait a little bit until they rise. Usually it takes about half hour or less or more, depending on the temperature of the room. Preheat the oven at 385 degrees. And I will put 1 cup of water in the oven to keep the oven moist. Moisture in the oven makes for good crust. I'll cover the bread with a couple of towels so it's nice and cozy. And when it rises, I will put it in the preheated oven. Arrange your pans in the racks so that there is air circulating around them. I mean, you know, they're not too snugly or touch one another. Okay. Now I will mist the breads on top with a little water. Just spray a little water on top of them because the white crust will be more flexible to rise without breaking up. 35-40 minutes baking the red now. Knock on the bread to make sure it makes this hollow sound. That means the bread is thoroughly baked. So we put the towel on top, flip them, see how easy they come out. Careful, don't get burned like I did.
So there you have it. The cuts make it easy to break. Enjoy.